a 235-foot claimed, and I then realised that this is the difference is the height of the pleasure beach above sea level.
That drop there, has it been done before? I don't think it has. Not as steep as that. It literally leaves a bloody track. It leaves a track as it's coming down. It's in air, suspended in air. It must be. Okay. Because the velocity, the air must lift it off the track and everything. There must be a little gap between all the wheels. There's got to be. You can never have everything putting up. So it must float. It must float.
There is a ride at Kennywood, which is the second mega coaster to be built. Now there, they have a very steep drop that goes down a cliff, but the ride and the pull-up of the ride aren't very high at all. But of course, as it's going down a cliff, they claim that their first dip is slightly longer than ours. But it starts from a very low height. Ours is just the highest roller coaster, and at the moment, we think the fastest roller coaster in the world.
This will always be the fastest roller coaster in the world because we're not starting at 0 miles an hour or kilometers an hour when we come over the hill. We are going about 18 miles an hour, so that's how we hit over 80 miles an hour at the bottom. So for all those roller coaster builders out there, you're going to have to go about 260 feet in the air to beat us.
So yes, there's envy. And there's one-upmanship amongst the curious breed of people who run amusement parks. But I think that the main people who benefit, of course, are the public, because they end up getting bigger and better rides.
It must be a wonderful experience. I'd love to have it too, but common sense prevails with me.
I look at it with a lot of longings, especially when I look at this big dip, and I really would have enjoyed that, I know, very much.
The ultimate roller coaster is always just around the next bend. The ultimate roller coaster is just going to be built next year. I can't believe what they've done with roller coasters already.
One character somewhere through the years said the ultimate roller coaster is one where everybody comes back to the station dead. Now, that's a little bit too wild to suit me and most people, I think.
I'm not sure I would want my dream roller coaster to be built. If it were built, then I would want another dream.
Every day, it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey.
Brace yourself next on BBC Two for Pavarotti and Domingo in New York.
Love like yours will surely come.